Hello students, welcome to the online classes. Today we will continue with our chapter 7, that is congruence of triangles. Okay, today we will study about the congruency criteria. Students, to tell that the two triangles given are congruent, there are certain criteria we need to follow. Okay, so first one is SSS criteria. What does this SSS means? It means side and side. It means that all the three corresponding sides of one triangle are equals to the corresponding side of the other triangle. Okay, as here you can see, this is the triangle ABC given and this is the triangle PQR given. Here this symbol represent that this side AB is equals to this side PQ. Here this double line represent that AC is equals to PR, and these three lines represent that these two sides are equal, means BC is equals to QR. As you can see that three of the corresponding sides of this triangle are equal to the sides of this triangle. It means these two triangles are congruent. Okay, means these two triangles are equal. By which criteria? By SSS criteria. So students, how you will write? In this you will write that in triangle ABC and triangle PQR. Okay, in triangle ABC and triangle PQR, as we are talking about these two triangles, okay, we will write that AB is equals to AB, this side AB is equals to PQ. So AB is equals to PQ. Here AC is equals to PR. So we will write here AC is equals to PR. And this baseline BC is equals to QR. So we will write BC is equals to QR. And students, when we write that this side or this angle is equals to this one, then we have to give the reason with each of the case. So here it is given in the question only that these two sides are equal, these two sides are equal. It means in the reason we can write that this is given in the question. Okay, so all these three parts are given in the question. Now we can say as with the help of sides we have proved that these two are congruent. So we will write that triangle ABC is congruent to triangle, this is the sign of the congruence, so triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR, and by which criteria? By SSS criteria. Okay, by SSS criteria these two triangles are congruent. Now moving towards the next criteria, that is SAS criteria. What does SAS represent? S means side, A angle, and S means again the side. Side, angle, side means we have to prove these two triangles to be congruent, and we have to check if SAS criteria it is following or not. So here also L, M, N and X, Y, Z, two of the triangles are given. So first of all we will write here in triangle L, M, N and triangle X, Y, Z. As we are talking about these two triangles, so we will write first in triangle L, M, N and triangle X, Y, Z. What we will writing first? L, M is equals to X, Y. L, M equals to XY. Now this angle LMN, as you can see that this is given. What does it represent? That this angle is equals to this angle. It means angle LMN, angle LMN is equals to angle XYZ, angle XYZ. Now this MN is equals to YZ. Side MN is equals to YZ. It is also given to us. So in the reason you can write students that all three things are given to us. Okay. Now by which property this is, or by which criteria these two are congruent? By SAS criteria. Students, you have to always remember that in this criteria, side angle side, as we are using these two sides, this one and this one, then angle must be using this one, means the angle which will be making by these two sides will be considered. Okay, we will not consider this one angle or this one angle. Why? Because we are not using this side to prove the congruency. Okay, as we are using this one side and this one side, so angle should be between them. Here also, as we are using this one side and this one side, so angle should be using this one. Okay, so then we can say that SAS criteria is following here. So we will write here that triangle LMN is congruent to triangle XYZ, and by which criteria? By SAS criteria. By SAS criteria, side angle side criteria. Okay, now next one is ASA criteria. ASA means angle side angle, angle side angle criteria. So here ABC and XYZ are given. So as we are talking about these two angles, so we will write in triangle ABC and triangle XYZ. First of all, what is given to us? That this angle is equals to this one angle, means angle BAC. What will be the name of this angle? As A is, it is at the vertex A, it means BAC. So angle BAC is equals to which one angle? YXZ. Angle YXZ. Why? Because it is given in the question only, in the figures it is given. Then this side AB is given to be equals to this side XY. So we will write that AB is equals to XY. This is also given to us. Now this angle is equals to this angle. As you can see, that double lines are shown on the angles, it means these two angles are equal. So what will be the name of this angle? ABC we can write. So angle ABC is equals to which one angle? XYZ. Angle XYZ, this is also given to us. Now by what criteria these two are congruent? By angle side angle. Okay, so triangle ABC is congruent to triangle XYZ by which criteria? By ASA criteria. Now students, in this what you need to remember is that what will be the side you will be using to show the congruency? The side which is common for both the angles, as this angle and this angle is here. So which side is common for both the angles? This side is common. Okay, if you will consider side AC, then only this angle is here. If you consider side BC, then this angle is here only. So we can't consider AC or BC, we need to consider AB only, because here this angle and this angle we are using. So the side should be common of both the angles, so that we can use angle side angle. Okay, similarly here also angle side angle, this side is common for both of these angles which we were using for the congruency. Okay, so that side will be used only, and then we can say that the two triangles are congruent by ASA criteria. ASA criteria. Now students, last one criteria is RHS criteria. What does RHS means? R means right angle, R means right angle, H means hypotenuse. Hypotenuse, and S means the side. Okay, so students, as the name is suggesting, right angle, so it means in the triangle there should be the right angle. So let us take this triangle PQR, and angle Q is 90 degree, means this is right angle. And here this is XYZ, we can consider XYZ, and here this Y is at the 90 degree, and it is given in the question at this PR is equals to XZ, this side QR is equals to YZ. Okay, Now, how we will show that these two triangles are congruent by RHS criteria? First of all, we will write that in triangle PQR and triangle XYZ, as we are using these two triangles. So, first of all, can we write, students, that angle Q and angle Y, both are same, both are equal. Why both are equal? Because both are of 90 degree. So, what we will write, that angle PQR, we will name this angle as PQR, and we will name this angle as XYZ, is equals to angle XYZ. Okay, what is the reason? Reason is each of 90 degree, because both angles are of 90 degree. Okay, now here PR and XZ are given to be equal. As this mark is shown, it means these two sides are equal. And students, if you will see, then this is the right angle, and we know that the side opposite to the right angle is called hypotenuse. So this PR is the hypotenuse. Also here this is the right angle and its opposite side is this one, so this is the hypotenuse. Okay, so here PR is equals to XZ, this is given to us, and also these both are hypotenuse. Okay, and last one is QR is given to be equals to YZ. QR equals to YZ given to us. Now students, we can say that triangle PQR is congruent to triangle XYZ, and by which criteria? By RHS criteria. Why RHS? Because see students, first of all we show them that these two angles are equal and both angles are of 90 degree, means right angle is justified here. Then it is said that hypotenuse. Now here PR and XZ are equal, and PR and XZ are also hypotenuse, so this condition is also satisfied. Then one of the sides should be equal, and here both the bases are equal, as we have written here, means one of the side is also equal here. So we can say that these two triangles are congruent, and by which criteria? By RHS criteria. So students, by this your topic and your chapter is over. Hope to see you in the next video. Till then, take care. Bye bye.